Hi everyone, I'm Marco Esposito, Head of Robotics at ImFusion. Our mission is to enable innovation for everyone. We help our industrial customers to go from inception to the market as fast as possible. May it be young startups going for their first medical device getting certified, or larger established companies that are expanding beyond their current market segment and skill set. And we also support our academic partners by cutting their engineering efforts so they can focus on their breakthrough research. We are a diverse team with a broad portfolio of competencies, all contributing to a single, consistent framework. Our technology stack conjugates the highest standards in software engineering, the latest innovations coming from research in domains such as medical image registration, removing all barriers between rapid development and innovation and deployment to production systems. Our libraries for image registration, freehand ultrasound compounding, and deep learning allow our partners, as well as us, to perform impactful scientific research, and they are already integrated in multiple already certified medical products. We set up this demonstrator for you so that Julia, Martina, and I can show you what we can achieve when we add our youngest module, robotics, to the mix. Our setup consists of a commercial ultrasound system from BK connected to a convex ultrasound probe and to a driverless manual frame grabber. The frame grabber, just like the Franca Panda collaborative robot, is connected to an NVIDIA Jetson GX Xavier. We are going to take a preoperative image from our patient, Julia, an MRI image, load it into our ImFusion Suite software, segment, deliver through deep learning, register this to a semi-automated robotic ultrasound sweep of her liver, and find a feature that we want to inspect with our ultrasound probe and send our robot there. All of this is going to run on this device, which supports a real-time kernel, which allows us to do custom robot control, and also all of our advanced visualization, deep learning inference, and unlocks all of the features of our framework that we need for this demo. Everything you are going to see is going to be a raw screencast of this device. First of all, we need a preoperative image. So we are going to load an MRI image of Julia's abdomen. We can achieve this with our advanced and fast DICOM loader. Here we can browse all of the series in this study. We are going to load our favorite image. Here we can see the liver with the naked eye, but we need a machine to find the liver. To this end, we put together a segmentation that we can run on this image. This runs through accelerated with CUDA. You can see that we have now a label map describing the position of the liver within our MRI image. Usually, you will not want to segment a whole organ for most workflows. You'll be rather interested in segmenting an object of interest, for example, a suspect lesion that you want to biopsy. To perform our semi-automated ultrasound sweep, we need to determine a suitable trajectory. We can do this by teaching it to the robot. So we can put it in gravity compensation mode, so that we can move it with our hands. We can start looking for a path that we want to travel on along the organ. So here we see the liver in the ultrasound image. This means that it's a suboptimal trajectory. So we go to the end of the organ and we can select our goal trajectory. Now we go back along the organ so that we can cover the biggest part of it that we manage. And then we can stop the gravity compensation. Now we can tell the robot to go back to the sample goal position and to acquire the ultrasound images as they are emitted by the ultrasound device and to put them together in a 3D ultrasound compounded volume. You can see this happening in real time in the 3D view. Now that the robot has stopped moving, we can register this 3D ultrasound image to our preoperative MRI. We see here our 3D ultrasound image, and we want to align it to the preoperative MRI. We have an image registration routine which is capable of registering any of the major modalities to each other, ultrasound, CT, and MRI. However, we need an initialization step for this, and we will perform it while I explain you what it consists. So we will ask our registration initialization algorithm to align the two images roughly, so that our local image registration can then align them to the precision that we require. Why do we need this step at all? If we don't do a good enough initialization, our registration will not be able to recover from a bad scenario. If we do take a naive approach, this will not work. We need to at least get the orientation right to some degree. How can we do this? We trained three different models, which are able to segment the gallbladder, the inferior vena cava, and the diaphragm in each of the two imaging modalities. This way, let's say that we can find the individual fingers of my two hands. If we have localized them, we can pair them to each other, and we can already find an initialization for our image registration, such that we can let it run and make it go to our desired solution. Now we can inspect the results of this procedure. And we see that the wall of the liver, as it is visible in both the MRI and ultrasound images, agrees for the most part. However, this result is not to the precision that we wish. So we can make our ultrasound image registration run to achieve a better precision. We can see our optimization running in real time. This ultrasound MR registration is using the LC2 metric to register these two wildly different modalities together, which is not easy since different anatomical structures can be visible in either of the two images, or not at all. After the image registration has run, you can take a better look and check that the visible anatomical features are well aligned in both in the two images. Now that we are satisfied with our alignment, we can use our setup to send the robot to a position such that a point located in one of the two imaging modalities, let's say the MR, is visible in the live ultrasound image. So if our deep learning model localizes a lesion here instead of the whole organ, you could take its center of mass and ask the robot to move itself such that this point is visible in the ultrasound image. You can inspect that this is the case by switching back to the live view of the ultrasound image and check that the point that we marked is visible in the image plane. Now that the robot is looking at what we told him to look at, we can use this live ultrasound image, for example, for a needle biopsy. This is a standard navigation workflow that is well supported in our framework. This is just an example of what can be achieved by freely mixing and matching the modules of our framework and by developing a custom plugin for the ImFusion Suite, our rapid prototyping environment. Our APIs make it a breeze to develop such a complex workflow constituting of custom robotic control, ultrasound image processing, DICOM image loading, multimodal image registration, and deep learning inference. Explore and follow our YouTube, Twitter, and LinkedIn profiles to know more about our framework, including more modules, such as the Computer Tomography Reconstruction Library or the RGBD and Vision modules. Thanks for your attention and stay tuned for more.